Hello friends, welcome to this video on CAT 2019 slot 2 DI, second part of this video. Again, in the first part we covered two DI sets. In this part we covered remaining two sets. So let's start with the DI set. Okay, so here is the question. Okay, a large store has only three departments: clothing, produce and electronics. The following figure shows the percentage of revenue and cost from three departments for the year 2016, 17 and 18. The dotted lines depict percentages level. Okay, percentage level. For example, in 2016, 50% of store's revenue came from electronics department. So we are talking about this part again. Here, this is the part we are talking about. Okay. Then 40% of costs were incurred in produce department. Okay. So 2016, 40% were in produce department. So this is the point we are talking about. In this chapter, profit is computed as revenue minus cost, and profit percentage profit as profit divided by cost into 100%. So what we can say is, okay, we have to find data of, okay, so we need to find means we should have record of revenue, cost and profit. Okay, even if we can ignore profit, okay, because we know revenue also. Okay, so what I'll do is, okay, I'll make a table with details. Okay, so first part, let's say, is about revenue. Okay, and the second part is about cost. Okay, so this is for revenue, this is for cost. Then we need 2016, 17 and 18. Here 2016, 17 and 18. Okay. We can write each of the components, which is electronics, clothing and produce. Okay. We can write total here. And these are the values which we have to fill up. Okay, pardon for my writing. Okay, in this setup, okay, we have already done that. The profit percentage for the store in 2016 was 100%. Okay, and then store's revenue doubled from 2016 to 17, and cost doubled from 2016 to 18. There was no profit from the store's department in 2017, electronics department. 2018, the revenue from clothing department was the same as the cost incurred in produce department. Now, if we are not given exact values, okay, we are just given percentages. What? So, the easiest thing which we can do here is, okay, we can start with values. Okay, so we have initial value of profit percentage in the store was 100%. Okay, so I'll write this as 100 in 2000. Sorry, cost is 100. Okay. If I write cost as 100, revenue will become 200. Okay, in terms of value, because 100% profit is there. Store's revenue doubled from 2016 to 17. So this value will be 400. Okay, and the cost doubled from 2016 to 18. So this is 200. Okay, so we have used both the statements. Okay, there was no profit from electronics department in 2017, we can find the revenue. So revenue in 2017, if you see from here, this orange line here is 30%. 30% of this number is 120. Since there is no profit, that means revenue and cost were same. So I can write this as 120. From here, we can find the total cost in 2017. Okay, let's go here. It is 40%. The total 2017, 40% cost was incurred in electronics. 120 is equal to 40%. That means this has to be 300. Okay. So we have used this one as well. Okay. So now we know this total. We can find other values. Okay. So we will do it later. Okay. In 2018, the revenue from clothing department was. Revenue from clothing department was same as cost incurred in produce department. Cost incurred total we know. Cost incurred in produce department is this. Okay. cost incurred in 2018 in police department is 50% of the total cost, which is 200. So cost incurred from police department is just 100. This is same as revenue from clothing department. Revenue from clothing department, so I'll also write here 100. Now if you know this, okay, which is revenue from clothing department in 2018, the green lines, okay, clothing department, this is 40%, this value is 100. 40% of total is 100. That means the total 100% will be 250. So when we know the totals, we can find all other values, okay. So now it's time to solve the questions, okay. We'll not find the values, okay, we'll just use the numbers, okay, because we can save some time, okay, doing that, okay. Let's start. What was profit percentage of the store, okay, in so I'll just move it a bit up, okay. What was profit percentage of store in 2018? Cost is 200, profit revenue is 250, so profit is 50 out of 200, so this 25%, okay. I'll just enlarge it a bit, so we can write the profit was 25%. Okay. What was the ratio of revenue generated from produce department in 2017 to 18? Okay. Produce department revenue 400. Produce department will go in 2017. 17 is orange line, which is 40%. Okay. Of 400. And in 2018 also 40% of 250. Okay. 40% is common. So we can write this. This is 400 by 250, which is 8 by 5. Okay, guys. Okay. Now let's move ahead. Okay. What percentage of total profits of the store in 2016 was from electronics department? Now, if you see, total profit in 2016 is revenue is 100, profit is 200, sorry, revenue is 200, cost is 100. So total profit is 100. If you see electronics department in 2016, revenue was 50% of 200. Okay, so electronics department revenue was 100. And cost was if you see, sorry, we did this line, okay, which is 30% of total cost. 30% of total cost is 100. So 30% of total cost is 30. So this is 70. So answer of question number 3 is 70. We have to just type in the answer, okay. Question number 4. What was the approximate difference in the profit percentage of 2017 and 18 of the store, okay? In 2017, the profit is, if you see, 400 is revenue, 300 is cost. So, in 2017, profit is 100 by 300, which is 33.33%. 2018, it is 250, the revenue, and cost is 200. So, the profit is 50 out of 200. Which is equal to 25%. The difference is 8.3. So answer of this question is option 4. Okay. So I would say this was very solvable set. Okay, it could have been solved within 6-7 minutes. Okay, so should have been attempted definitely. Okay. So look out for such sets. Okay, when you see just numbers and you have to just calculate, you don't have to apply logic. Okay, makes your the solving process easier. Now let's go to the second set. Now this is again a data driven set, okay. I'll read the information first. To compare rainfall data, IMD calculated long period average LPA of rainfall during period June to August for each of the 16 states. The figure given below shows the actual rainfall during June to August 2019 and a percentage deviation from LPA of respective state in 2018. Each state along with its actual rainfall is presented in the figure. Okay, so I'll just move up a bit. So we have actual rainfall on x-axis, deviation from LPA, on y-axis. This is positive and negative, okay, in terms of percentages. Okay, so let's start solving. Okay, if a heavy monsoon state is defined as a state with actual rainfall from June to August 2019 of 900 or more, so 900 or more, so this is the line, so we have to go on the right hand side. Okay, sorry, 900, this is the line we are supposed to follow. Okay, what percentage of heavy monsoon states, okay, out of the states which are on the right hand side of it, okay, have negative deviation from respective LPS? Okay, so first of all, we have to calculate total. So from this point right hand side, we have only data points 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 7, so 7 is denominator. How many have a negative deviation? This is line 0, so we have 1 2 3, 3 by 7, 1 by 7 is 14.28%. So I like, so this is 42.85% or 86% approximately. So answer is option 1. Pretty easy question. Okay, we have to just calculate, means add, means count the number of data points. Okay, question number 2. If a low monsoon state is defined as state with actual rainfall from June to August 2019 of 750 mm or less. Okay, so we have to see this line somewhere here. This is, okay, so this is 0. Okay, this is the line. Okay, so this line somewhere here, 750. Then what is the median deviation of the LPA? Okay, deviation. So we have to see the deviation here, okay, of low monsoon states. Okay, so from this point, okay, if you see, if I draw this point, this is the point we are talking about the for the second question. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, okay, items. Okay, out of 9, we have to find the median. Median, so we have to, from top to bottom or bottom to top, okay, fifth item. Okay, so because we have 9 such states, okay, so we have to find fifth. So we'll go from top, 1 2 3 4. This is the state we are talking about, which has deviation of -10%. So median is -10%. Pretty easy. Again, what is the average rainfall of the state that have actual rainfall of 750 or less in 2019? Okay, and have negative deviation from LP. Negative deviation, so we have to see below the line. Okay, and 600 or less. Okay, so this is the point. Okay, so we have, if you see 1 2 3 4 5, these are the states we are talking about. So we have to find their average. Okay, average, so we see 600 plus 600 1200 1200 plus 600 16 16 plus 300 19 19 plus 4 2300 divide by 5. So we'll get 460. Okay, so from this point, okay, the states with negative deviation. So we are just looking at the bottom part, this part. Okay, so these are the five states. So the answer is 1 460 mm. Question number 4. LPA of a state for a year is defined as the rainfall in preceding 10 years, considering the period of June to August. For example, LPA in 2018 is average rainfall during 2009 to 18. LPA in 2019 is average of rainfall during 2010 to 19. Okay, so we are given LPA of 2018. Okay, so that is something which we need to remember. Okay, now it is observed that the actual rainfall in Gujarat in 2019 is 20% more than the rainfall in 2009. So if you see, Gujarat's rainfall is here 600, okay, which is 20% more in than 2000. So this value is 600. If this is 20% is more than in 2009, so 600 divided by 1.2, okay, so this value is 500. That means the value, the rainfall in 2009 was 500, in this year we have 600. LPA of Gujarat in 2019 is closest to, okay, so we have to find what is the LPA in 2019. Okay, now if you see, Gujarat has deviation of 25%. Okay, so 600 this year has positive deviation of 25%. So LPA in 2018 is, if you divide this, it will become 480. So LPA of Gujarat for 2009 to 18 is 480 because the current this year's rainfall is 25%, deviation is 25% more than the LPA. So 480 was the LPA. Okay. Now we have to find new LPA. Okay. So 2009 is gone and 2019 is added. So if you see the deviation between these two means the difference between these two is 100. Okay. And that is spread across 10 years. Okay. So extra 100 spread across 10. So we'll get additional 10 value. So 480 was earlier average. Now it will be 10 will be added. Okay. So the new LPA 2019's LPA is 490. So answer of the question is option 4, 490. I'll just repeat it again. So till 2018 we have LPA equal to 480. Okay. Now in 2019 the rainfall was 500. Okay. 2009, sorry, 9 and 2019 is 600. So 2009 is gone, 2019 is added. So if you see the overall increase is of 10. Now since we are finding the average LPA's average across 10 years, so we're getting 10 100 extra across 10 years. So on an average per year we'll have extra 100 by 10, 10. So earlier LPA was 480, now the LPA should increase by 10, which is 490. So again this was also very solvable set. Okay, one advice I'll give you is, okay, most of the times, okay, the calculation based or counting based BIs are lot easier to solve. Okay, so please look out for such sets, okay, and you should be able to solve these sets very easily. Okay, that is all for this video. Okay, thank you very much.